The following is a paid program.
We may not have done everything we promised, but we have fulfilled 90% of our manifesto promises of delivery. In 2010 and 2011, we worked hard to revitalize our country after the economic decline under the previous government. We then succeeded in achieving growth in 2012, 2013, 2014, and 2015. Even with the fall in the price of oil, we ensured we kept our economy on track by ensuring a continuing flow of investment from global companies like Shell, BP, and Mitsubishi. Not only investment in our country, but more jobs too. We have created more than 57,000 new jobs in Trinidad and Tobago. In our second term, we'll continue to create more jobs for the people of Trinidad and Tobago.
That is the leadership she provides. That is why she can't tell none of them nothing. And all of them is alligator from the same murky lagoon.
Our unemployment rate is down to the lowest at 3%. This means that about 94% of our population labor force is gainfully employed.
Morning, Mr. Warner.
It is the $10 million question at the center of FIFA's global bribery scandal.
The $10 million, where did it go?
Cash promised by South Africa. And sent to this man, former FIFA Vice President Jack Warner.
Can you tell us where the $10 million went, Jack? Mr. Warner, where did the $10 million go to? Can you tell us one project, Mr. Warner? Can you tell us about one project that you spent the money on? Jack Warner doesn't want to talk about the missing millions.
We have delivered goods and services. We have implemented policies which have drastically improved the lives and lifestyles of all our citizens. And that is why we have done infrastructure, healthcare development, schools, roads, bridges, drains. And when we say we are giving laptops to children, did we pick out UNC? Top partnership we gave across the board to all the children. When you leave here, you will see the Kuva, the children's hospital, off the ground, ready to open, ready to commission, ready to go.
I want to tell you something. I'm from Miss Noel in Tobago. Miss Noel, very close to Lekoto. The last time I was put out of anywhere for anything, the person who put me out regretted it.
I will stand and fight with everyone and anyone. I have no fear of them. None whatsoever. The only thing I fear is my God. The only thing I fear is my God and yours. But as long as we put God in front and walk behind, we have nothing to fear. Nothing to fear.
Five minutes after the hour of 6 o'clock. Welcome all and sundry. Welcome to the election platform.
Let me say a pleasant good evening to all and sundry. All of you are lock on listening to yours truly, the Gladiator. Good evening to the original Fausto and the crew. Lock on to the program via an iPad. So good evening to all of you listening, those of you in your vehicles making your way home, those of you at your home listening. Good evening, good evening, good evening to all and sundry. This evening, I have some issues to discuss. Now, I told people that I am buying over the fight. Like other talk show hosts and callers to talk show programs, I am standing on the side of the Prime Minister as a PNM. And if that so-called pastor devil tile has a problem with that, I'm coming to you just now. I'm coming to you and this next imposter Googles. Yes, I'm coming to all you just now. Have some patience. I'm coming to all you just now. Now, citizens of the Republic, I have listened to the antics and the politics of the Secretary of the Police Welfare Association. I want to deal with he this afternoon. The Police Service Social and Welfare Association Inspector Michael Seals. Now, this man, Michael Seals, Inspector Michael Seals, for that matter, he's an attorney at law. Yes, he is an attorney at law. And also a police officer in the rank of an inspector. You also have Anand Ramesha, who is the president of the Police Social and Welfare Association. He's also an attorney at law. But you see that statement that you made on national television? You see that statement that you, Michael Seals, made on national television? But let me tell you this. I think you better pack your bags and get ready to exit the police service. Here it is. We are in the season of general election. And let me tell people, I'm opening up the lines very early o'clock because we have to address this matter very seriously. So let me give all the numbers one time because I'm discussing this matter in the first part of this evening program here. And the numbers are 8255. This man, Michael Seals, descended into the political arena. What caused you to make a statement like that on the question in which you used the word provoke on two occasions? You used the word concerted effort on one occasion. But let me read what was published in inverted commas, quotation marks, to put it in a more clearer way. According to Michael Seals, the fact is that the intelligence coming to us at the association is that there is a concerted effort to bring a situation about that they provoke the membership of the police service so that the membership will react outwardly. You went on to say, and so let me say publicly an appeal to the membership, please do not be duped into doing anything foolish, because the reason why we are saying that is because we are hearing that there is a position to provoke the police so they can call a state of emergency to delay the election. Such statement, citizens of the Republic, is one of the most irresponsible statements any police officer could make publicly. And this calls for disciplinary procedure. Now, it's not that Michael Seals was given a paper to read. He's an attorney at law. He's a very, very intelligent individual. But when you could descend into the public and join in the bandwagon of that scumbag, better known as Austin Jack Warner. Yes, that scumbag. And when you want to join in the hip parade of this wannabe Prime Minister Rowley, and you want to create a situation, alarm the citizens, because we are in a very tense moment. We are in the general election, and you're using the words, check the words that you are using, Mr. Seals. You use words as provoke. You must know the meaning of the word provoke. When you use the word concerted effort, you must know what you are saying. You must know what is the message that you are sending outside there. A man like you cannot be in the police service. And after that investigation, I'm absolutely sure the only result or the recommendation is that you be dismissed from the police service. Let me start to take calls. We are discussing this afternoon here. Let's take call because we have to discuss it, because y'all are going too far. If it is that y'all have issues with this, take call because we have to discuss it, because y'all are going too far. If it is that y'all have issues with the government concerning wage negotiation, well, wait for Rowley. Wait for Rowley. But don't come and bully the Prime Minister and make this kind of irresponsible statement in a time of election. Good evening, caller. Good evening.
Pleasant evening to you, Brother Gladiator.
Good evening to you, Tabakit.
I just heard the 6 o'clock headline news on Channel 4. He was suspended.
Yes, I have the document here.
He was suspended.
Yes, he was suspended.
You see, these fellas is bordering, and what is happening now, Dr. Rowley is sending out his mouthpiece in the police service. And I want to congratulate the Acting Commissioner of Police, Mr. Williams, and those who took that decision to deal with this man. Tabakit is saying, well done. Brother Gladiator,
yes.
Be strong. Fight the fight. Stand strong, Brother Gladiator. We are standing with you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And he will be dismissed from this police service when they finish with their investigation. Good evening, caller. I mean to say, we will have to wonder whether Jack Warner is going to rush to his defense, because there's nothing to defend there at all. Good evening, caller. Hey.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Hello?
Yes,
yeah, good evening, Marita.
Yes.
All right. While I disagreed with Mr. Steele's statement, right? I think one of the most constructive things he would have said is that security officers do not be duped. So he didn't incite any officers.
No, he may be told. He may be told the officers don't be duped. The mere reason that he made the statement, he used the word provoke. When you use a word provoke,
one minute, please.
Let me tell you, in the first instance, Michael Seals is a police officer in the first instance.
Yes.
If it is that you have received intelligence, you don't go.
Is a police officer also wears the hat of a member of the Police Service Association, Canadian Industrial Court, the Cadu Supreme. You being a police officer and one also being, sometimes they call it in the court, a shop steward, but in the essential service, he's a member of the association.
Right.
Right?
Thank you, caller.
Yes.
And at the end of the day, citizens of the Republic, you don't go on national television and tell the nation that you receive intelligence. You are a member of the police service. And you are saying that the government is plotting something. You use the word concerted effort. You are saying that the government is engaging in a plot. You are saying that the government is engaging in a conspiracy. That is a serious, serious, serious allegation. Good evening, caller.
Good afternoon, Gladiator.
Good evening.
Yes, and heaven help us all if the politics reach in the position of police in high position in any country, any part of the world.
Yes.
The protective service have no right to be leaning on political side, especially
don't descend
the public domain.
Don't descend into the political arena. Leave that for the politicians.
All right, let them go ahead. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much. I am saying do not descend into the political arena. You want to be a Calypsonian? Do like those guys when it's carnival time. Go and sing your song and sing what you want to sing. When you want to be, if you want to be a Calypsonian. You want to be a politician? Resign from the police service. But don't stay within the police service and make these serious allegations against the government. Come on. Good evening, caller.
Yeah, Gladiator. Good evening.
Good evening. Yes.
Gladiator, I could safely say, I have been a member of the protective services for 30 years.
Yes.
Right? And I could have never made a comment politically under the institution where I was, and that is the regiment. Because it would have shown that I am not loyal to the sitting government. And I think that the police service is under that same regulation, that they cannot make these kind of political statements to show that they are favorable to our government, because they will not be loyal. And if the Police Service Welfare Association, the second division, that is, I must say the second division, saying that they receive information, how come they bypass the acting police commissioner with that information for him to come and make a statement like that? I thought a statement like that may have come from the acting police commissioner and not Mr. Seals, right? And it just goes to show where the beam of light they are sitting on. And Gladiator, the acting police commissioner has said that we have to rid the police services of rogue cops. And this is what the
police
is to the extreme.
That is a rogue behavior.
Is a connection.
Yes.
Where we're connecting the dots to the total day of policing.
Yes.
And where it actually came from, Gladiator.
Yes.
It's just a matter of time everybody does expose themselves. And I didn't even know that they suspended him. It's only I called somebody when I heard it at a program just now that he was suspended. But I was appalled that he could make a statement like that to put the country under tension, that it have the government provoking the police of it to hold a keep a state of emergency. Gladiator, that is ludicrous.
I tell you,
an irresponsible farmer like that rank in the police service,
yes,
to make a comment like that. And I not only certify suspension, I will certify dismissal.
Yes.
Right? The police service is good, Gladiator.
Yes.
They are good officers. But I will support the police, acting police commissioner, to get rid of the rogue cops. And we see where the feed of the other junior and subordinate police officers have become coming rogue because of people who hold that level of responsibility.
Thank you.
Listening.
Thank you. And the government must get the best attorneys at law. He must not return to the police service. He must be dismissed after the disciplinary proceedings. The government must set an example. They must put their feet on the ground. If you want to negotiate for your salary, go ahead and do what you have to do. But don't be making this kind of statement. Good evening, caller.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good evening.
I am so happy that this man is out. he is out of place. He is trying to incite riot in this country. I'm so happy. I hope Madam Felicious could pick up that and talk about that, you know.
Nah, Madam Felicious ain't gonna talk about that at all. She ain't gonna talk about that. She will go on the radio program tomorrow, on the Mugabe radio program tomorrow, and say, oh God, honestly, they can't say nothing, they can't say that, they can't do that, what have you. Because, you know, she like backing her and she does boast about it, Madam Felicious. She does boast about that, you understand? So you don't expect anything like that at all from coming from her at all, anything responsible, more things that are irrational, you understand? Good evening, caller.
Yes, good evening, Gladiator.
Good evening.
They know she's going to show the true colors. This fella, Mr. Fields, he is one of the rookups, you understand? And they know what he's trying to do is to incite the population and to give PNM people the edge to say that they want to call a state of emergency to delay the election. These fellas only flying kite, just like Jack Warner, flying kite right through. All their idea is to bring down this government at any cost. But they now start to show up. They're coming out, the little worms coming out the woodwork, and we have to slap them down one time. He must never see the police service anymore.
They
must get rid of them once and for all.
Thank you.
These are the men who are trying to put Mr. Abraham out. He's fighting to get Abraham to get out of the service. You know why? Because they want to continue the corrupt practices.
Thank you.
And I support anybody that say get rid of him.
Thank nobody. Let me tell you, people, there is no argument over that at all. When you read the Police Regulation Act, understand, that kind of conduct from a member of the police service, most importantly, he being an inspector of the police service, that kind of conduct, the only way out for this man is out of the police service. Out of the police service. Good evening, caller.
Yes, good evening, the Gladiator.
Good evening.
Later, my question to you and to this public, I want to know that if the police service in this country or Chichen and Tobago police service have no confidence in the Prime Minister and the government.
Well, that is a nice political question. And we got the answer on television from Michael Seals. Thank you. I tell you, get a master's degree on the click to the switch. You ask a good question. And the question that you ask is a political question. And the answer that you're looking for is what we got from Michael Seals. We got it from Michael Seals. Let me tell you this. I tell you, go and study political science. Earn a master's degree. You ain't ready yet. You're still an ABCDarian, a political ABCDarian in this realm. Next. Good evening, Colum. Good evening.
Gladiator.
Yes.
That statement was one of the most irresponsible statements ever
irresponsible statement.
On the population of Trinidad and Tobago.
Of course.
That statement was designed to create public ridicule and to incite
of course.
The population in a particular direction.
Yes, yes.
And I now see why crime cannot be solved in this country. This man got intelligence about what a state of emergency.
But this man is
so low, Gladiator. Crime in this country. Where is the intelligence?
But this man is an attorney at law within the police service. He's an attorney at law.
You see where it comes to politics? That's a different thing, you know. You just lose all, like it is overtake you.
But
it's clear now that there is some hidden agenda.
Yes.
You should know better. Listen, you know what you are saying there?
Yeah.
You know what a statement like that could do to a lot of countries?
Yeah.
Even somewhere in the Middle East, you know what happened in this place already?
Yeah.
It will be chaos and mayhem.
Thank you. So much years it's taking the police to conclude in the email gate fraud and scandal. It's taking so long. There's no intelligence from Michael Seals about who is responsible for the email gate scandal. We do not know of any intelligence as to who is responsible for the drugs in Sadiq Bash tank. We do not know with regards to who killed Selwyn Richardson. Where's the intelligence for that? We do not know who is responsible for the policing just the other day when they blocked down the whole country. No intelligence. But you, Michael Seal, all of a sudden you have intelligence. And the only place you thought fit to divulge that information is to go public with it and not discuss it with the commissioner or report it to a police station. Good evening, caller.
Good afternoon, Gladiator, again.
Yes.
Now, concerning that email gate you now touch on.
Yes.
This police service must bring that before September 7th because I want them to know the allegation on that email gate, we are in the process of electing a prime minister. A prime minister is a person holding one of the highest office in the land alongside the president. So I hope they're not planning to keep that inside until after the September 7th. I'm waiting patiently in Trinidad and Tobago as a voter waiting to make my rights in the democracy.
Thank you. Here it is, the police service don't have any intelligence of how to turn off a cell phone on a plane. No intelligence to turn off a cell phone on a plane, but you have intelligence that there's a concerted effort to provoke the police officer to call a state of emergency in order to delay the next election. I mean, say, this is an alarmist position that you have taken, Michael Seals, and the only way out for you is total dismissal from the police service, and that is what they're going to head into. Good evening, caller.
Good evening, Gladiator.
Good evening to you.
Gladiator, Madame Felicia's husband is a policeman, you know, so she always taken for the police, you know, so you go hear she in the morning.
Yeah. Well, what do you expect from she? Madame Felicia's. What do you expect from her? She already said that she's a fanatic, she's an illiterate, she's a dunce, she's what have you, what have you. You cannot expect anything better from she. You understand? You cannot expect anything better from her. But the thing about it is that this thing here by Michael Seals have to be addressed. This is a very, because, I mean, it's people, I mean, tell me if I am not, if I'm wrong. We are in a tight situation. It is the mother of all battles. The temperature is rising every day. And you come in the middle of this whole scenario to make an irresponsible statement against the incumbent government during a period of election. Well, I come into you just now. I come into you just now. Because he must address bisect. Well, I come into you just now. I come into you just now. Because he must address bisexuals. He must address that. And he must address pedophiles. I come into them just now. Yeah? Good evening, caller.
Gladiator, this is the first time in history the police don't have confidence in our prime minister and in our government in this country called Gladiator. This is the first time, Gladiator, and we must support Sister Kamala. I'm saying Sister Kamala is not my sister. I'm saying your prime minister is not my sister. I'm saying my leader, Austin Jacquona, is my sister. And
yes,
I am saying,
all right, thank you, thank you. You just said it. I didn't say it. What you see, y'all rushing that Jack One is your sister? Did I hear that? Jack One is your sister? But what the hell? What the hell? Nah, maybe I didn't hear clearly. Good evening, caller. Maybe I didn't hear clearly at all.
Evening, Gladiator.
Yeah, good evening.
Gladiator, I want to commend the assistant commissioner, the acting commissioner, and his executive for taking that decision.
Thank you. We know what went through in 1990. We know what took place here in 1990. And here it is, all of you had back men ganging up against the prime minister. And I told you all, you know, I told you all that I am not making no joke. This comeback, Jack Warner, yes, you must listen every day. You must listen every day. Damn scumbag. Y'all are trying out how to bring down this government. You're trying out how to bring down the prime minister. And this lady withstood the test of all time of any political leader in the history of this country after Eric Williams. In 1981, when Eric Williams died, George Chambers took over and they put pressure upon pressure on George Michael Chambers. He gave in. Then came A&R Robinson, they shoot him up. He gave in. Then came Patrick Manning. He gave in. Then came Basio Pande. He gave in. He called early election. Then came Patrick Manning again. And under pressure, he called early election. But the prime minister withstood this test of all times. She was able to make the full 5 years. And they use the best. They choose the best. They choose my leader, Dr. Keith Rowley, to bring down the prime minister in the first year. He failed. To bring it down in the second year, in 2011, he failed. In 2013, he failed. In 2014, he failed. And the Prime Minister is still riding strong and strong and strong. Good evening, caller.
Gladiator, could you allow for important one last contribution, please?
Of course, of course, of course.
Right. Gladiator, you just always say, and I commend you for that, you always warn that the Prime Minister is not an easy person and she's not stupid. I have heard you said that over and over again on your programs that you're saying, and people never listen to you. And I want to ask you a question, Gladiator, this evening. Would you agree that these so-called rogue policemen in the police service are undermining the acting police commissioner by not giving him interesting and relevant information so he could direct and conduct the police service in a clear and transparent manner? Would you agree with that, Gladiator?
Well, when you apply deductive reasoning from what you're saying, one has to agree with it. One has to draw the conclusion that that is what is happening right now. Because these police officers,
somebody before he is dismissed, they should charge him for inciting anarchy in the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. Because all our programs, all what we have seen in Trinidad and Tobago in this republic, are being heard elsewhere outside in the Caribbean and worldwide.
Yes.
These things are serious things, and that is the extent. If that is the extent that a man could reach in a protective services, who people have confidence in and to keep law and order in a country, could make a statement like that, Gladiator, he should be charged, he should be dismissed, and he should be faced, should be hauled before the courts of law to be prosecuted in the proper manner, Gladiator. You. If you agree with me, you could say yes. If you don't agree with me, well then fine. But this is just my opinion. Thank you.
Well, rest assured, the angle that they are going to take is disciplinary proceeding against Michael Seals. Not because he's an inspector, they wouldn't do that. They will go through that channel. And civil actions is going to emerge out of this matter here. Understand? Civil action is going to emerge out of this matter. He can no longer speak on behalf of the police service because he's suspended. And because that kind of behavior, that kind of conduct, is gross misconduct within the police service. How can you make a statement and you start with the premise is that the fact is that the intelligence coming to us, what intelligence coming to us? Who are the people behind this intelligence? You will have to explain that, you know. Because when y'all were before the parliamentary committee, y'all couldn't give an answer. So who are the people or the perpetrators behind the policing throughout our country when there was gridlock all over the island? But just recently, you're going to open your mouth because y'all feel y'all could say anything all you want under this government and get away with it. That must stop. Good evening, caller. The time has come for people to be responsible, especially people who are holding office. Do not jump into the political arena and make this unfounded, irresponsible statement. It's not that you're an ordinary police officer, an ordinary constable. You're an inspector. Good evening.
I cannot understand some of these callers and them at all. You need to make your strong contribution. This Kingsley keep on calling in. Save that for when you're on the other frequency. Right now we're dealing with a matter that we're facing here in this country here. We don't want no kind of outer timing thing right now. You see that junk food? We don't want that.
Thank you. You see what happens, Adam? You like the limelight. You're on TV, the nation listening to y'all. Understand? The CPO offered y'all 14% in salary wages increase. But y'all feel that y'all could bully the government to demand more. And if y'all can't get it, y'all are going to undermine the government. And you took the brave step to make that irresponsible statement. Good evening, caller.
Brother Gladiator, have a kid back.
Yes.
Gladiator, you're trying to unfold this thing. Well, let me help you to unfold it. You see that fella they call Ansel Roger? Ansel Roger is the chief cook and bottle washer. You see, the encourager is worse than the thief. And I like where you're going, Gladiator, this evening. I want you to go to the head of the class. Because what you is saying, we want to know all who behind this thing, this conspiracy, and the man who is to the head of this. This thing started Labor Day. It started from there. The conspiracy was hatched there. And the fella who is to the head of this nastiness is Ansel Roger. Ansel Roger is the man who wants to help destabilize this country with Dr. Rowley. Kavakit is saying this morning, this evening, sorry, Ansel Roger, I call you out. You is the man who's setting up this coup d'etat against the government. Kavakit out and off.
The views of the last caller is not the views of Gladiator, neither the views of this radio station. I just wish to make that pronouncement. But coming back to Michael Seals, you make a statement about intelligence. And this is what we have been asking you for the longest while. And when I say use the word you, the police, we have been asking the police to give us a report on Emailgate. Where's the intelligence of Emailgate? Who is the perpetrator or perpetrators behind Emailgate? No, the police don't have no intelligence gathering at all. Who are the one or perpetrator behind the assassination of Dana Sita Hall? Where's the intelligence, Michael Seal? No, they don't have that. All of these areas who caused the gridlock throughout the country. And you have this one on television telling people they have to walk with their food some other time because they have more to come. That is the man who have the set of gold ring and gold chain on his neck. Yeah, what is his name again, boy? He does be on that TV6 channel. And poor people, you put them up, most wanted, and it's only because they don't have money to sue you for defamation. Inspector Alexander, it's only because these poor people don't have money to sue you. Because what about the big shot people who have maintenance? You ain't putting up the picture at all. You ain't putting up the picture on TV6 at all and have them as most wanted. I mean, I am seeing some breaches of people's civil rights and fundamental rights and freedom. Only poor people, they put up their picture and have them as most wanted, most wanted, most wanted. A day you will make the mistake and one of them people is going to sue you for defamation of character. Good evening, caller. Good evening. And that's when they have too much power. That's when, you know, they have too much freedom. Too much freedom. Put pressure on the CPO. You ain't get what you want at all. So you go on national television and you make an alarming statement. Now,
national
television. Good evening, caller.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening.
Good evening. It's a long time that's supposed to be put to a halt where the police service intention is to be like a runaway train. They can't solve nothing, they can't detect nothing.
Yes.
How many things have they ever solved and detect within recent times? You know what I'm saying? I'm afraid to say, if it was in the military, he would have been, that fella called Seals, for the longest while he and Anand Ramisa have been like a runaway train. If it was in another place and in the military, them was history. Thank you again and have a good day.
Thank you. Holy calls, holy calls. It was yesterday, citizens of the Republic, I told people, because yesterday was a very busy day, and I got so much calls from people. Gladiator, you have a pastor by the name of Pastor Devil Tile. Some people has mispronounced it as Devil Tile. But this Pastor Devil Tile, who have been attacking and slandering the name of the Prime Minister, because, you know, I told people, I buying over the fight. So you have this so-called, but he's not a pastor, people. Let me make it clear. He is not a pastor. He's not a bishop neither. This devil tile, who claims to be a religious man, wage war against the gladiator. Wage war. And let me thank the people who supplied me with a copy. And right now, I have it before some transcriber who are transcribing the audio of those programs. And then you have this next imposter who like to fool people at night and call himself Googles. That is on the Mugabe radio station. Their mission is to bring down the Prime Minister, encourage people to insult the Prime Minister. Yes. Encourage people to insult, slander, and defame the reputation and character of the Prime Minister. Now, this devil tile, I want him to answer the question, because I tell people, leave me alone. If it's war you want to enter into this political arena, leave me alone. Because I don't blah, 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 blah. I just conduct my own investigation. But I wanted to hear for myself. And I heard it today. It was emailed to me. The program with he and Aisha Wells. Yesterday. He and Aisha Wells. Yesterday. And I thank them for emailing that program for me. And also emailing me a next program. So them feel they could play devil in the daytime and play holy men in the nighttime. You so-called imposter, I want you to answer some questions now that you are in the political arena, because it seems as though you're seeking high office. I want you, when you're having your sermon and you're cussing up the Prime Minister, you must speak about the man who had sex with a 13-year-old girl and caused the girl to abort the child. The man is about your age. I want you to expose that. The man has seven children. The man is also a bisexual. Yes, devil tile. Expose that on your so-called devil program. Now the fat pig. Yes, the fat pig. Yes, that Googles. Why it is you like people to call you Googles? Eh? What happened? You don't have a name at all? Eh? You take the internet name Google and call yourself Googles? Eh? You, another fraudster, imposter. You must tell people what you was doing in the United Kingdom all them years. Tell them. But you playing, you want, all because I took over the fight for the Prime Minister. You see, I know all the good, you know. The public don't know all the at all, you know. This next one want to con people to get money, to travel all over the place. And devil tile, you must tell them why the same man
who having sex with a 13, who had sex with a 13-year-old girl, why it is, he said, but that is a tradition in Africa. And in Africa, it's a tradition to have sex with a underage girl from 12 years old. From 12 years old? I want you, Devil Tile, investigate that pedophile, that nasty scumbag, that pervert, who is also a bisexual and has 7 children. Now the fat pork, yes, fat pork Googles. Oh my God, you stress mommy sauce. You like Lambie? Every morning you want Lambie. Begging the woman every morning until she get fed up. Every morning you want Lambie and have the daughter's girl, the fallacious madam. Lambie, line up a Lambie. Yeah, daughter's talk. And all the cussing up the prime minister every morning. The same madam fallacious, she and all get fed up bringing sandwich for you. You want to talk about Gladiator? I don't be sleeping in Mugabe radio station on a couch, leaving my stinking scent. If I have, no, I bed. And I also have on cologne. I put on cologne. But people who have to come to work on a morning have to smell the stench because of you, Mr. Porkman, the fat Googles. But why are you telling people that your name is Googles? You say you are a religious person, but you don't want people to know your real name. Why you don't want people to know your real name? I've given you until next month to stop calling yourself Google and declare your real name, because you know you have a nasty, dirty past. You see, all the ones that attack the prime minister, encourage people to slander, encourage people to defame the character of the prime minister. And because Gladiator say he buying over the fight, all of turn the fight on me. As though I'm going to run, I wouldn't run, because I like to investigate people before I open my mouth. These two imposters, well, let me tell you, fat pork, you gotta sell that pork on Murray Street. Yeah, fatty Google, fat pork Google, you gotta sell that pork on Murray Street. Yeah. You want Lambie? Sell your pork and buy Lambie. You want to join with Jack Warner? Sell your pork. Sell your pork. And when you're selling your pork, do the Gooty look back. Olo, leave me alone. If you want to see me and Jack Warner fighting, don't jump into this fight. Olo, bunch of hustlers. Yeah, you, these two pastors, disgracing. I mean, I say, when workers at the Mugabe station could call me, they say, Gladiator, put on a work on them two fellas and then put on a work. I say, no, I don't have to put on no work at all. I must first investigate them. I want information. Information I want. And I want this man, Devil Tile. You see, I don't talk until I hear for myself. And I got the audio recording. I got it. With you and Aisha Wells yesterday. All of Buff of the Gladiator. Nasty my name. Dirty the name. Attack my reputation. All because I say enough is enough. With this attack against Kamala Prasad Bisesa, at the end of the day, she is our prime minister. But no, y'all don't want to talk about the 66 books of the Bible. Y'all don't want to talk about the 39 chapters of the Old Testament, the 39 books of the Old Testament. Y'all don't want to talk about the 39 books of the Old Testament. Y'all don't want to go into the details and in the depths of the 27 books of the New Testament. Y'all don't want to discuss that at all. Y'all don't want to discuss the 1,189 chapters of the Bible. You're lying to the people every night. You're saying all I want to pray for this nation. But when all are praying, you're encouraging people to call in and make racist remarks against the Prime Minister. All of these filthy, nasty, dirty remarks against the Prime Minister. Now, I don't get up. I don't stay up to listen at all. But I have people who just email me the copies of the program. I am not going to waste set up any night for Sukunya to listen to a bunch of Sukunya. Eh? A bunch of Sukunya and devils. And you have this devil child, eh? Who doesn't want to expose a man who's a pedophile. Sexing a 13-year-old. I now can understand why you're all against the Prime Minister. And I'm saying this. Any candidate that is going up for the partnership, any candidate that is a pedophile, interfering with underage girls or have a past history of underage molestation of girls, boys, whosoever they are, if the partnership only sent up a person who's a child molester, I am going to condemn that person on a daily basis. Here it is, these two pastors, they're condoning child molestation. The next one, the fat pork, Googles, a very sick man, the same so-called devil child, lying to the nation and talking about he have herbal medicine. Herbal medicine. And want to sell, I said, a garbage to the population. He ain't gonna give the fat pork, the so-called Google, who doesn't want to declare his name, because he know the day he declare his name, is then people will know what kind of character they're dealing with. They gang up on people. They gang up on people. Madam Fallacious, gang up on Tuna Puna and join words for Tuna Puna whenever she get the chance. Carry it at all. She feel that her sweet voice could sell the PNM. Consume it, dance. Well, let me tell all you, all of now become a tag team with Warner leading in front. Warner leading in front, and you have this so-called reckless leader want to come after because he want to be Prime Minister of this country. And then it have all you who want to gang up against Gladiator. All that to be mad, all losing all the marbles. I say go and sell your pork. You Googles, go and sell your pork on Murray Street. And do the dirty wine. Do the dirty wine, yes. You Googles, let me tell you how to do the dirty wine. You plainly want to jump into political arena? Put your thumb finger in your mouth. Put your blasted thumb finger in your mouth. Turn your head to the side. Make sure you look back. And cock your boomsie up. And wind back. Wind back. The time has come for you to sell your pork. Here it is. I bought the war. I bought over the fight. It's me and that scumbag Jack Warner. People eating mud cake in Haiti. And you have this devil child boasting that he has 7 children. Yes, boss. But talk about the bisexuality. Talk about the child molestation of a 13-year-old girl. I want you to preach about that. Preach about those pedophiles. Yes, you. And stop lying to the people. And if you want a person to join in the chorus, go to Madam Fallacious. Let me tell you people this. We are in the election season. Are taking on all of y'all. Leave me alone. Keep me out of all the bacchanal. My fight is against those who making racist remarks against the Prime Minister. My fight is against those people who hold in public office. Jack Warner holds public office. Jack Warner stole $750,000 from the Haitian relief fund. Cannot give an account for it. You, Jack Warner, watch who you're sending against me, you know, because they will have to join with the Fat Pork on Morris Street. They will have to join with Googles. Yes, you, Googles. You and your Fat Pork. When I engage in battle, I am a serious fighter. Don't come into the arena. If you're not ready for the tension, if you're not ready for the battle, stay in the pavilion. Ask Tuna Puna about it. If you're not ready for the battle, stay in the pavilion. Ask Potter Spain about that. And you could hold your Psalms prayer. I hear them advertising that you want a night of prayer to pray, to engage in your obia. How can a man like you pray? You, Googles, a fraudster, an imposter. Yes, you. Pray on your Fat Pork. Yeah, don't be sleeping at the Mugabe radio station, leaving a stench, sweating. I mean, they say, they complain you burp too much. My God! I mean, how can a man be doing that? And you're begging for Lambie? You want Lambie water? You want Lambie water? You, Googles? You want Lambie water? Sell your pork. And that next cross, yeah, all of a sudden overnight, you read one or two little scriptures in the Bible and use a master of theology. You become a bishop. And the kind of language and the kind of talk you carry on. Eh? And you trying to mobilize people. No wonder why people didn't follow you. When all of the mass jump to Shagaramas, nobody didn't take you on at all. Because people know your files. They know your files. On too many occasions, you have too much con artists in this country here. Eh? When they want to hide themselves, they become reverends. Yes, they call themselves pastor. Some of them call themselves bishop. Some of them call themselves all kind of titles. And they do that to hide their past. Yes? I mean, they say, when I listen to the recordings and hear the defamation and the slander of Gladiator's name, I say, my God, Father, what have I done to these people? But you know, every good thing must come to an end. And I make an appeal to you, Googles. Sell your pork! What the hell wrong with you? They want a pung of your flesh on Morris Street. And do the Gucci look back. Sell the pork!
That was a paid program. Power 102.
Your 2015 election station. Make informed decisions this election with your voice and your vote. Power 102. Where the real power is. Your voice, your vote. Where the real power is.